And straighten out Imo State, where the House of Assembly has suspended three members indefinitely. The Speaker of the House, Honorable Kennedy Ibe, announced this on Thursday. The members are Arthur Igwim, who represents Idaton North constituency, Ngozi Obiefole from Isu, and Obinna Okwara, who represents Nkwere. The Speaker also declared the seat of the member representing Ngokpala State vacant. Now, the reason given was that when the governor presented the 2022 budget, the House promised to give it an accelerated hearing. These lawmakers ignored to participate in the sitting, and the Speaker was angered with their action. Therefore, they were suspended. Meanwhile, supporters of the suspended lawmakers from their different constituencies say they would protest against the suspension of their representatives at the State House of Assembly. Now, joining us now is the publisher of CKN News, Chris Nwande. Good evening to you, Chris. Many thanks for joining us on the News Now on PLUS TV Africa.
Thank you very much for having me. Good evening and Merry Christmas.
Yeah, Merry Christmas to you. Let's try and understand some of the issues in Imo State. Now, from what we hear, they were suspended because they did not attend the governor's budget presentation. Is this legal, or do you think there is more to this than meets the eye?
First and foremost, we have to understand that the primary responsibility of every lawmaker is lawmaking. And they also have responsibility of oversight functions on the executive, apart from constituency project as well. Then also, one of the cardinal reasons why they are also elected is also to be able to pass the look at the budget and pass the budget of the executive, one of which is the coming of the governor to the State House of Assembly to present the budget. So if they are not in plenary, then they must have cogent reasons to be at plenary while they're wearing there. And if the speaker finds it very, the whatever reason that they're giving that is not authentic enough to warrant they're not being there, the State House of Assembly has the right to be able to take any action against any member who refused to attend such an important event. But let us also look at from the point of what we have to look at is that what constitutes a quorum, because that is also another angle that we look at, because I don't think there's any law that says that every single member of that house or every single legislator must be in that plenary at any given point in time during any debate on the floor of the house. I'll take you to the National Assembly. What constitutes a quorum of the National Assembly is one third of every member of the Senate or every member of the House of Representatives. If it's going to be a joint session of the National Assembly as well, then it's going to be one third of every member of that assembly that constitutes a quorum. So under the circumstances for that of Imo State, I wouldn't know whether there's any breach in the members not attending. Then don't also forget that also Imo State have been having some political issues, especially in the State House of Assembly or precinct, which led to the impeachment of the former speaker of the current speaker. But that to me is what we need to look at. Then that of declaring the seat of a member of the House from Ngokpala. Well, I know that the speaker with the House may have the right to do that. If, because at any given point in time, in the life of every House of Assembly or legislative house, there is a minimum number of days that a member is expected to sit. If he doesn't meet that requirement, then he has breached the rules of that particular house, or even the National Assembly or either the Senate or the House of Representatives. And if he break that, then it can also be vacant. I think that is what happened in this case. But as I said, I don't know whether this is politically motivated or just following the rules of the House.
All right, now, but I really need to understand something right now, Chris. So why is this particular scenario different? Because we see this as a usual outlook, even at the National Assembly, where members are not consistent with their presence. Don't you think that this particular punishment might be a bit too grievous? What do you think, Chris?
Well, For me, I think that it is rather sad and unfortunate that when you look at, anytime you look at, when the camera pans on the, in the House of Representatives and Senate, you see the number of empty seats. And you continue to wonder where the senators and the House of Representatives members have gone to. Empty seats everywhere. But constitutional, as I said, the what forms a quorum of that legislature is one third of all the members. So if one third of the members are available there, they can sit. But that does not bring in robust debate, because every member of that Senate or House of Representatives or even State House of Assembly is supposed to participate fully in every debate that goes on in there. That is the only way you can get a much more better, robust legislature. But what we have, we just have members just absenting themselves. Some people travel, some travel out of the country, and they don't even attend plenaries. All they just wait for is at the end of every month, they get their alert and the rest of them, and that is it. That is not good enough. If what the Imo State Speaker has done is constitutional as it were, then I think that the Senate and the House of Representatives also follow suit that any member of the House of Representatives of Senate that refused to attend sittings at any given point in time, without meet of that, then there's a need for them to declare that seat. Because there are so many Nigerians out there who want to occupy those seats and be able to do the needful. But the situation where you don't see them attending is quite unfortunate.
All right, Chris, before we let you go, so would you say this particular development is actually a welcome one? And what other lessons are there to be learned?
The lessons to learn there is that people shouldn't see the legislative arm as just a place where you just go to retire. And that is what it has come to. You just see every governor that finishes his term, the next thing you see him finding himself in the Senate, and they just pick up this, they pick up the seat, and they don't even attend plenary. So we should be able to enforce. There's a law, Each of the houses, as I stated, the Senate and the House, as well as the various houses of assembly, have their laws that binding the number of days that people should, their members should sit. And if you don't be able to meet up that seat, I think that should, that law should be improved, and every member. So, to me, what is happening in Imo State is a very, very interesting one. And I believe that other state houses of assembly should follow suit and make sure that their members attend plenary. That is what they are paid for. These guys are collecting huge amounts and salaries or whatever, whatever you name it. And at the end of it, you don't see them attending and contributing positively to legislative matters. This should be a litmus test for all state houses of assembly and national assembly.
All right, we must say a very big thank you to Chris Nwando. He is a chartered conciliator and publisher of CKN News. Many thanks for sharing your input concerning the issues at the Imo State House of Assembly, Chris.
Thank you very much for having me. Do have a Merry Christmas.
You too, Chris.
Hello. Hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.